Some people may like it, some people may hate it, but Apple is surely onto something. I'm talking about the Apple's new liquid glass effect, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can create your own liquid glass effect using After Effects without using any third-party plugins. So that being said, there'll be time codes throughout this video so that you can skip and watch the part that might help you the most. So yes, let's get started. So firstly, what we're going to do is we're going to develop a system by using which you can convert your animation into a liquid glass effect. Let's take a new composition and let's rename it main comp, and let's keep the other settings as it is. So to create the background, let's take a solid. You can see the shortcut here, Control plus Y, and then let's rename it to BG. Okay. And then let's duplicate it using Control D. And let's add a grid effect. So you can't see anything because it's set to white. Let's set it to black. And let's make it bigger a little bit. And let's make it square. So now what we're going to do, we're going to take our adjustment layer by pressing Ctrl Alt Y. And let's bring that adjustment layer down. Let's take a circle. Let's draw a circle here. Let's set the color to a darker shade of blue. And now let's add a Gaussian blur. Let's increase it. You need to deselect it so that the blur spreads evenly. Let's make it 999 to give it a soft finish. In the adjustment layer, let's apply another Gaussian blur and let's make it 555. Okay. And let's duplicate it and let's keep it here. And for the grids, let's bring down the opacity to 25 and let's make the border 3. Okay, this should work. And also let's add a fill here. And let's make it slightly darker. And let's bring this to circle below the adjustment layer. Okay. So we are pretty much set for our background.
So now what we're going to do is let's select the rectangle tool and let's take a square. And let's make the anchor point to the center by pressing Ctrl Alt Home. And now let's increase the roundness to make it a circle. Okay, this should work. So this will be our base shape. So now what we're going to do is let's make a pre-comp and let's rename it to main shape. So now what we're going to do is we're going to convert this main shape into a adjustment layer. You can see it just disappeared because we don't have any effect applied yet. So I'm going to press Control Space to enable the FX console. It's a free plugin just to search your effects. You can also use them from here. So yeah, this is also fine. So let's go and add a transform and let's make the scale 110. Now you can see this is the layer. Now what we're going to do is let's add a brightness and contrast. Let's make it 5 and let's make the contrast 25. Okay, this should work. Now what we're going to do is let's duplicate this main shape and rename it to displacement. And here what we're going to do is we're going to make this also a pre-comp. Displacement comp, so that we have this pre-comp inside it. So when we change this shape, this will affect the whole thing. That's why we're going to do a double pre-comp here. So now let's make it a normal shape layer, and also let's just duplicate it two more times and let's rename it to bevel and rename it to edge light, and we need another one for the shadows. Okay, let's delete these effects from all of the duplicates. You can just delete then duplicate, it will be easier for you. So in the displacement, let's add a layer style inner glow. Let's set the color to black and blending mode to normal. Let's increase the size to 250 and let's make the range 75. and make sure to enable the rasterization in the displacement map. So go to the main shape and add a displacement map. And here set it to displacement and this to effect and mask. And for the horizontal displacement, we're going to set luminance for both horizontal and vertical. And let's make it 55. And let's also make the vertical one 55. So now what we're going to do is let's hide it for now. Now you can see the effect. But we want the middle portion to be less affected. So what we're going to do is in the main shape, we're going to duplicate this displacement map. And let's set the value to minus 55. And we will also set the value to minus 55 here. Okay, so now you can see that we got this effect. So in the main shape, let's add another effect, CC glass. So from the CC glass effect, let's increase the height to 10. And what we're going to do is in the light option, we're going to make the light height to 75. And from here, also enable the rasterization for the main shape. And now let's enable bevel. And let's add a fill and let's make it black. And here we're going to add layer style, bevel emboss. Let's make the size 20 and softness to 25. Okay, and we are going to set this bevel layer to screen mode. Okay, and we need to also reduce the opacity of the shadow so it gets softer. Now let's go to edge light and let's also add a fill layer here. And let's make it black. Let's add CC light sweep. And let's make the direction 0. And let's keep the anchor point in the center. Let's make the width 200. Intensity to 2, edge intensity 90, and let's make it 9. Okay, now you can see that we got this edge light here. So we are going to duplicate this edge light and make this 180 to get the same thing on the opposite side. And now let's add a glow. Let's make the glow threshold to 20, and let's make the radius 55 and intensity 2. And we need to also set this to screen mode. And now we are going to add the shadows. Let's go to the shadow layer and we're going to add a layer style, inner glow. And this time we are going to make it black and set this blending mode to normal. Let's make the size to 50. And let's increase the range to 75, I guess. I think we can reduce the size a bit. Let's make it 150. Okay, this should work. And let's set this mode to multiply. And now we're going to bring the shadows below to the displacement. And now we are going to add a Gaussian blur in the shadows. Let's make it 55. And let's bring it down a little bit. Okay, we can reduce the opacity to 75, I guess. Yes, so now let's add a null and let's parent everything to the null. So here you can see that we got our glass effect and now we can start the animation. So to add animation, let's go to the main shape and let's animate it. So firstly, let's do this one. So to do this, let's add a keyframe here and let's reduce it a bit. Okay, now let's duplicate this keyframe and let's unlink it and increase the width. So now you can see we got our base animation, but what we need to do is to make it apple smooth, we need to do some adjustment in the curve. Let's make them bezier curve and let's go to the graph editing mode. And make sure you have the speed graph enabled. So I'm just going to make it. Let's bring it a little closer. Okay. So now what we're going to do is we are going to add an adjustment layer. In the adjustment layer, we're going to add a turbulent displace. And let's reduce the size to 20. And click on the evolution by pressing Alt to add an expression time times 150. And also we're going to animate the size a little bit. Keep it 100 in the middle portion and let's make it 2 here. And let's also keep it 2 here. Okay. Now if you go to the main comp, so we got this animation. So for the second one, what we're going to do is let's hide this. And let's another rectangle. Let's make the anchor point snap to center and let's middle align it. So now what we're going to do is we're going to increase the roundness. And let's make it 450. And let's increase it a bit. Let's bring it here. You can reduce it a bit. I think let's make it 400 or maybe 350. Make it 850. Okay. And now we are going to duplicate this. And let's make it 350, like a circle. Okay. So now let's animate them to merge into a bigger circle. Let's add keyframe in the size and position. Let's do the same for here. Now let's select both and press U. So we're going to build an anticipation by making them go from apart from each other. Then we're going to merge them into a bigger circle. So let's bring them closer. And also let's adjust the size of it. So let's make it 350. Let's both align to the center. And now let's make this 400. No, I think we should go with 500 and 500. Okay. I think we should keep the height consistent from till here also. Okay, so let's duplicate this one and make it 520 into 520. So we got this. Now what we're going to do is we're going to adjust them. We're going to make them bezier keyframes. And we got this. So here to build some anticipation, what we can do is we can adjust the position speed. This one. Let's also adjust the position speed of this. Yes, so we've got this. Now we are going to merge them so they have a connection. Let's bring up the adjustment layer. And what we're going to do is we're going to add a Gaussian blur. Let's make it 100. And we're going to add a simple choker. Let's increase it to 30. So now here you can see that we got this connecting line. I think we can make it. Okay, so now you can see that we got the connection again. Now you can see that the size got reduced. So what we can do is we can add a transform here and we can just scale up the whole thing by 120 and this should work. So now if you go to the main comp,
so we got our second animation also, and you can experiment with different shape and different object also. Thank you so much for staying till the end. If you have any kind of confusion, feel free to comment below. And also, if you want to have a more personalized interaction, feel free to join the Discord server. It's totally free. If you are someone who is into AI and want to learn how you can boost your efficiency with the help of AI, feel free to watch this. And also, if you want to learn how you can convert your 2D image into a 3D model, feel free to watch this. And I'll see you there. Ta-da!